Hello everyone, in this video,
I'll cover the basics of Git. We all have created various versions or copies of Excel files using date to keep track of the changes we make in them. However, this isn't practical as the code base and the models keep changing with time. So to keep track of the changes we make, we have something called as Git. Git is a version control system which has three blocks: working, staging, and local repository. Working is where you make the changes, staging is where you verify the changes you've made, and the local repository is where you save all your changes. I've created a simple file called file.txt, and now I'll go over the basic commands of Git. Before we go ahead, I hope all of you have installed Git and made the basic configurations. So let's get started. Firstly, I'll have to tell Git to monitor this file. So the way you start off is by the command git init. I'm inside the directory where I have my file called file.txt, and now when I do git init, it says initialize an empty git repository in that specific directory.
Now I've told git to keep track of the file that I've specified.
How do I check what it's checking is by a command called as git status. So it says that there is an untracked file called file.txt and there's nothing to commit. Currently your file is just in the working directory. You want to add it to the staging directory. The way you do that is by the command called as git add dot or git add the file name. What you've done is
the file which we had, which was file.txt,
you've now pushed it to the staging directory. Now let's see what is the current status. Now it says there are no commits yet and there are changes to be committed. So you have line 1 being reflected on the staging directory as well. Now what I'll do is I'll first make my first commit, or I want to keep a checkpoint of the file in my current working directory into a local repository. So the way I do it is git commit minus m and a commit message accompanying that. So that would be my first commit. So it says my first commit, one file changed, one insertions, create mode, some number and the file name. Now when I do git status, it says on branch master, nothing to commit, working tree is clean. What this simply means is when you say git status and it says there is nothing to commit, that means that all the three blocks you have in Git, which is working, staging and repository, have the same content of that particular file. That's how you interpret this. Now I'll show you the basic idea of how git diff works. Now in my current working directory, I'll add a line called line 2. Okay. Now when I do git status, it says that the file is modified and you have changes to be staged. I'll show this again. So it says that the file is modified and you have some changes for commit, but also some changes for staging.
Now I'll stage the changes from my working directory to the staging directory.
So I'll say git add file.txt.
Now when I do git status,
it says that there are changes to be committed. Now I'll make one more small change. I'll add a line 3 in my working directory. So this is the current structure of my three blocks. I have three lines on my working directory, two lines on my staging directory, and one line on my local repository. Okay. At this stage, if I do a git status, it says there are changes to be staged and there are changes to be committed. Now, this is very useful when you have modified some part of the code, you don't know what to commit. This is where Git would help you understand what is the difference between the different stages of your file. Now, when I just do git diff, it gives me the changes between my staging index or my staging directory and the working directory. So if you see, Staging directory had line 1 and line 2. Working has line 1, line 2, line 3. So this is what your git diff would give you. It would give you the difference between staging, that is on staging what is there, and on your working directory. I hope all of this is making sense. Now, if I want the difference between my repository, that is the local repository, and the staging index, what I'll do is I'll say git diff minus minus staged. This would give me the difference between the local repository and the staging index. The colors signify the file in which they belong. So I hope all of this is making sense. Now, if I want to check the difference between my local repository, that is this guy, and the working directory, I'll just do git diff head. And now if you see, this is my local repository, this is my working directory. So with this, you can find out the differences of the three structures in Git and modify your code accordingly so that you can create proper checkpoints. If you do have any questions with what we have covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos across with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so very much for watching.